Let's start off by importing different media that you can bring into Autodesk Smoke via the Media Hub. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. There are a few ways you can import media into Autodesk Smoke. You can import media by clicking the File menu and selecting Import. Or you can right-click in the Media panel. The final method is just to click the Media Hub tab at the bottom of the screen. The Media Hub is essentially divided up into two sections. On the left is the Media panel containing your libraries and folders. This is the Smoke database containing all your source media and sequences. On the right is the File browser, where you can access all locations available to your system. This could include local storage, network connections, and shared networks. If you wish to go to your Mac user folders, click and hold the Bookmarks button and choose User Home. This will instantly take you to your common user folders like Desktop, Documents, and Downloads. Clicking the Home icon will always take you back to all the devices visible to your system. To locate media, simply double-click on a device to start navigating through the folders. The file path is displayed at the top of the file browser. If you want to manually enter the location of your media, just double-click on the current path field and it will open a keyboard where you can type in the file path. Just press Cancel and you can continue to navigate the folders in an intuitive way. Once you have arrived at your desired folder location, you can click the Bookmarks pull-down menu and choose to add a new bookmark. This lets you quickly jump back to your favorite location if you are browsing elsewhere in the system. The Media Hub will show your media as clips before you've even imported them into the library. Supported streaming media formats, as well as image sequences, are displayed as singular clips by default. To scrub the frames in the clip, you can click and drag on the gray bar beneath the thumbnail. You can also double-click on any clip to bring up the preview window. The preview window offers you a bit more extra functionality compared to just scrubbing thumbnails. For example, you can use the In and Out buttons to set an import range for a specific clip. Let's say you film an hour of footage and you only want to import a few seconds. You set the In frame and Out frame, and when you import the media, Smoke will only bring in what you want. There is also extra information available in the Clip Info and Metadata tabs. The Clip Info tab tells you about the generic details of a source, such as its resolution, format, and timecode. The Metadata tab gives you more specific information relative to the format. For example, you would be able to see the metadata coming from a Red or ARRI media clip. If you need to adjust the metadata setting for any format, you would choose the Format Specific Options tab, and you can adjust the various metadata settings for the selected clip. Now you can also adjust metadata settings in the sequence during the middle of a project. But if you're just starting out in Autodesk Smoke, I recommend that you set your settings prior to importing so you know what you'll get. Now before you import your clips, you can decide if Smoke will manage your media. You can opt to import the files in its native format and keep it where it is, or have Smoke transcode the footage into the intermediate format that you selected when you set up the project. This transcoded footage is copied onto the volume containing the Smoke Managed Media folder. You selected this volume when creating the project. Switch to the General tab, and under Clip Options, you will see that Cache Source Media is turned off. When this function is disabled, you can import the footage into Smoke and work directly with the native source. If Cache Source Media is enabled when you import media, Smoke will background transcode the footage into the intermediate format. You're able to monitor the transcode process through the indications at the bottom of the interface. You can also click on the arrows at the bottom left of your screen to bring up the console. This window is always available. Just click anywhere on the interface to hide it. In this case, the project is set to use ProRes HQ as the intermediate format. You should be able to start working straight away with the native sources, and Smoke will automatically swap in the intermediates as they are processed in the background. I'll turn off cache source media so that I'll be working with the native sources. To import any media into the library, you can select the clips and press the import button, or simply drag the clips from the file browser into the media panel. Dragging the clips to a library will add them into the Smoke database. If you already have folders inside your library for organization, you can also drag media to the existing folders to keep better organized. You can also import an entire folder, including subfolders and the media they contain. This operation will recreate the same folder structure inside the library that matches the folder structure on the hard drives. One final tip, you can also import files by dragging and dropping from the Mac Finder into the library. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.